नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, कंटिन्यूइंग द डिस्कशन ऑन द वर्किंग ऑफ आईसी इंजन, आई वुड लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट द फ्यूल इनटेक इन इंजन टुडे। फ्यूल पोजेसेस केमिकल एनर्जी विच इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू थर्मल एनर्जी थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ कंबस्चन। थर्मल एनर्जी इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रोटेशन ऑफ क्रैंकशाफ्ट। कंबस्चन इज ए chemical reaction where oxygen is other essential reactant. Atmospheric air is the source of oxygen which we use for the combustion of fuel in an engine. Therefore, it is essential to supply air with fuel to engine. The basic knowledge of chemistry tells us that for complete reaction, the reactant should be in proportionate quantity. That means a certain volume of air is necessary for complete combustion of a particular amount of fuel. Variable load on engine makes the things more complicated. The requirement of fuel and air varies with load. For proper working of engine, precise proportion of fuel and air is required. It is known as stoichiometric mixture in terms of chemistry. With petrol, stoichiometric air-fuel ratio is 14.7:1. Because the time available for combustion is not sufficient, there is a possibility that combustion remains incomplete. Complete combustion means that exhaust from engine is totally free from unburnt hydrocarbons or partially burnt hydrocarbons. I assume that you are aware hydrocarbons are the main constituent of organic fuel that is being used in engines. To overcome this, the air-fuel ratio may be 18:1. This is an ideal mixture. Air-fuel mixture with more fuel is known as rich mixture, whereas on the other hand, if the quantity of fuel is less, then it is known as lean mixture. Lean mixture with air fuel ratio up to 23:1 is used. On the other side, a rich mixture with ratio 7:1 is difficult to ignite. In case of compression ignition engines, we are using diesel as fuel. In these engines, only air is compressed inside the cylinder. The fuel is injected in the cylinder towards the end of compression stroke. The fuel is required to be in atomized form. Atomized form is the term used for fuel that has been converted into extremely fine particles. This helps in vaporization and combustion at later stage. In SI engines also, with introduction of fuel injection system, petrol in atomized form is used. As already said, different load demands the air-fuel mixture in different ratios. Considering the practical situations, number one, as we start the engine, rich mixture is required. The engine is in cold condition. It is said to be in cold condition when being started for the first time in morning. Cold climatic conditions could make requirement of rich mixture more essential. Number two, under idling conditions also, rich mixture is required. Mixture formation is poor during idling. Therefore, extra fuel helps in proper combustion. Lean mixture will cause intermittent firing. This produces higher amount of unburnt hydrocarbons in exhaust. Number three, while cruising, lean mixture can be supplied. Slightly higher amount of air helps in complete combustion of fuel. Number four, while accelerating also, rich mixture is required due to sudden opening of throttle. Number 5. To get the maximum output from engine, rich mixture is required. However, it increases the specific fuel consumption and causes inferior exhaust. This is particularly applicable to heavy vehicles and racing cars. However, economic and environment considerations being top priority, air fuel composition is not even kept stoichiometric. Greek letter lambda represents the proportion of air and fuel in the mixture. For stoichiometric mixture, its value is 1. As it represents air fuel ratio, 10% rich mixture means the value of lambda is equal to 0.9. Similarly, for 10% lean mixture, the value of lambda is 1.1. The graph shown represents the power available from an engine with respect to air fuel mixture composition lambda. As indicated, with increase in the value of mixture composition lambda or mixture becoming lean, the power output goes on reducing. It may also be noted that mixture with very low value of lambda or very rich mixture does not provide maximum power from engine. In SI engines, air fuel mixture is supplied to the cylinder. In 1885, Daimler and Benz came forward with surface carburetor. Prior to this, diffusion type carburetors were used. Both used the exhaust gas to heat the air that formed fuel vapors. The mixture of air and fuel vapors was used. Surface type carburetor given by Daimler and Benz could be considered to be the first carburetor for automobiles. Carburetors are modified from time to time since then. Simple carburetor that was used in automobiles for decades had an intake for air. Air passed through venturi with throat. It worked on Bernoulli's principle. Throttle valve controlled the flow of air-fuel mixture to engine cylinder. Referring to the diagram of a simple venturi carburetor, we find that it consists of small fuel reservoir with inlet, float and metering jet. The fuel from tank enters the reservoir through inlet. The float keeps the level of fuel in reservoir constant. The metering jet permits limited quantity of fuel to discharge nozzle. This nozzle is located in the throat of venturi. It sprays fuel. The air is supplied from upper end. On the lower side, there is a throttle valve. It is in the form of plate that can move about its middle point. As can be seen in the diagram, the vertical position of plate permits maximum passage to air-fuel mixture. Its horizontal position permits minimum passage and thus minimum supply of air-fuel mixture to engine cylinder. Electronic controls improve the carburetors a lot. The fuel efficiency of the engines witnessed a huge rise that made carburetors complicated and costly. These are replaced by petrol injection system. Petrol injection systems were introduced in 1954 by Mercedes. Some racing cars used direct injection system developed by Bosch. Petrol injection systems improved the working of engine and therefore replaced the carburetors gradually. Now they are almost obsolete in SI engines that are used in automobiles. Petrol injection system. Injecting petrol directly in cylinder head is quite complicated. The reasons are: number 1, It has to enter the cylinder against the rising back pressure caused by moving piston towards the end of compression stroke. Number two, injection of fuel has to be progressive to allow its atomization and mixing with air before spark. Number three, complete evaporation and formation of homogeneous mixture is difficult in short time that is available. Number four, carbon builds up on injector nozzle that adversely affects its working. The solution to these difficulties is low pressure injection. It is carried out at a pressure of about 5 bar. Let us take up different components of injection system. Fuel injector. As the name indicates, it injects the fuel. The fuel comes out of it in the form of spray. Atomized fuel particles form this spray. It may be a single spray injector or dual spray injector as shown in the diagram. In case of single spray injector, the fuel is sprayed vertically downwards as can be seen on left hand side. Dual spray injector has nozzles inclined uniformly. The sprays come out at an angle as shown in diagram on right hand side. It may be observed that spray is well distributed in the cylinder that makes it more effective. Next, let us try to understand the details of fuel injector and its working. Referring to diagram, the fuel enters from the top and passes through filter. In normal situation, solenoid is not activated. The fuel passage is closed. When fuel is to be injected, the supply of current activates the solenoid for a very short time period. This causes the plunger to move upwards. This clears the passage of fuel. It flows down and is injected in the form of spray. Electronic fuel injection. As shown in the block diagram, an electronic control module or ECM receives inputs such as engine speed, coolant temperature, air intake temperature, parameters in induction manifold, and exhaust through sensors. After processing these inputs, ECM sends information in the form of output signals to various components of engine. ECM is a processor that has been programmed for specific purpose. The information received from engine sensors help in providing correct amount of fuel for different load conditions. The electronic device is highly efficient. It is capable of controlling the fuel supply for different load conditions very accurately. Electronic control module or ECM processes the information from the following sensors. Engine speed sensor. It monitors the speed of engine continuously and is helpful in its operation at different speeds. Coolant temperature sensor. It conveys the temperature of engine and makes possible its operation at proper temperature. Manifold absolute pressure sensor. Located in intake manifold, it monitors the pressure and amount of air drawn into engine. Oxygen sensor. It is located at the exhaust manifold. It helps in determining the amount of fuel in air-fuel mixture by monitoring the amount of oxygen in the exhaust. Mass airflow sensor. It monitors the mass of air entering the engine and is located in intake manifold. Throttle positioning sensor. It monitors the position of throttle and regulates the amount of air going in the engine. Initially, single point fuel injection systems came into existence. However, they could not survive, though they were simple and had low price. The extinction was due to three problems. Number one, fuel tends to condense in induction manifold. Number two, it evaporates off in uncontrolled manner. Number three, a hot spot was essential in the throttle body to facilitate evaporation. Stringent emission control was another reason that made these systems obsolete. In due time, these were replaced by multi-point fuel injection systems. Multi-point fuel injection system. In this system, fuel injector is provided for each intake port, as shown in the diagram. The fuel pump starts working as soon as engine is switched on. It builds up pressure. The fuel is drawn by pump and then it goes to filter. Here, dirt and any solid contaminant that may be present in fuel is removed. Filtered fuel goes to individual injectors through fuel distributor. Fuel pressure is maintained with the help of pressure regulator, and excess fuel is sent back to fuel tank through it. The sensors from ECM are connected with each injector. The injectors are grouped together. As can be realized that it is a four-cylinder engine and there are two groups. Injectors operate alternately in each group as shown. Two injectors operate together when intake valve is just about to open. In other two injectors, fuel charge is stored in their intake manifold. Duration of this storage may be around 150 milliseconds. This duration is very short and has no adverse effect on fuel condition. With increase in engine speed, the storage time is further reduced. There is another variant of fuel injection system. It is known as sequential fuel injection system. In this system, ECM controls each injector separately. This eliminates the waiting time that we saw in multi-point fuel injection system. Here, mixture proportions can be adjusted instantaneously before injection. This makes systems highly accurate and efficient. So, here I conclude the discussion for today. Thanks for watching the episode.